Basulchit beak doa tsuch uktip ab bak kiltik, yech kuditschaat chitz kuchia. Welcome to Cape Flattery on the Makah Indian Reservation at the northwest tip of Washington State. Makah people, or kuditschaat, have lived in the Cape area since time immemorial, and our life has always been directly connected to the surrounding waters. The Olympic Coast National Marine Sanctuary was established in 1994 and lies just west of our traditional villages along the Strait of Juan de Fuca, extending south beyond our southernmost village of Ozette on the Pacific coast all the way to Quinault territory. From Cape Flattery, you can see the migration of whales and seals as they head north to spring feeding grounds, then south to birthing grounds in the fall. Some of the whales cut their trip short and spend the summer feeding here in the nutrient-rich waters created by the dynamic intersection of the Strait of Juan de Fuca and the Pacific Ocean. The seasonal offerings of this rich ecosystem of marine mammals, fish, and other intertidal vertebrates have sustained Makah people for countless generations. Not only were there enough ocean resources to sustain our population historically, but Makah people were well known for trading our surplus whale oil, halibut, and fur seal to people in areas extending far along the coast and into Puget Sound. Land and sea are closely tied together in Makah culture. Visit our world-class Makah Museum in Nia Bay for a more in-depth view of Makah life predating European contact. Understanding the properties of the many ocean and land resources allowed macaws to make technologically efficient tools to harvest fish, intertidal foods, plants, mammals from the land and sea, and more. These tools were also used to decorate ceremonial pieces and other special items. The first European explorers arrived on our coast in 1788. They were met by Makah warriors in war canoes launched from Tatoosh Island, who made it known that they were not welcome in Makah territory. In 1855, Makah representatives signed the Treaty of Nia Bay, where they agreed to give up large tracts of land while reserving important rights to traditional resources. They wanted to ensure our way of life and livelihood for future generations of Makahs in perpetuity. But the demand on resources, driven by the new trade and new populations, proved to be too much for the ecosystem to sustain, and local fish and sea mammal populations plummeted. Today, many marine mammal populations have rebounded. In fact, the recovery of the gray whale population is considered a success story, and seals and otters abound. Yet, our access to some of these resources is still limited. Through managed fisheries, halibut stocks have also recovered in our area, providing macaws and other commercial and sport fishers the opportunity to harvest these bottom-dwelling flatfish. The Makah tribe continues to co-manage very diverse fisheries, including marine mammals, to ensure these important resources are available to our people. These lands and waters have been managed and protected by Makahs for centuries, and now the tribe works in collaboration with the Olympic Coast National Marine Sanctuary to enhance resource protection. By working together, the tribe and the sanctuary, along with other partners, will ensure that these waters and coastlines remain rich, vibrant, and productive for generations to come.